everybody, welcome back to the channel. What's good? I'm Kiva. So, gotta chime in on your boy Tariq. I thought I was gonna say Derek then. I'll get to him at another date. But he posted a video. What I'm confused on, was it his video or was he posting just a video how he posts videos of incidents? Because I'm not clear. The comments read as if Tariq was at that hotel and he posted it, okay? So that's where I need clarity. Nonetheless, he posted the video and captioned it, "Mayonnaise worker, why, has a breakdown or whatever with black man." Why is the caption like that? Why is the person a mayonnaise? You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I never knew who Tariq was until I saw people talking about him. I went on his page, of course, to take a look. Nothing on it interests me. I did not hit the like button on his page. I am not subscribed, but, you know, I was going through his messages. A lot of the messages in that thread, as you will see here that I'll try to post, people was not supportive of that. This young man said he had a mental illness. So we can't say, well, why was he working in customer service? Because you can't discriminate against people. People mentally ill are able to cope at whatever level they can cope at and work. And he's probably never experienced anything like that. And also sometimes they just need to step away. The video, of course, because we never going to record in the full context. The video starts with him saying, well, why did you punch the, why are you taking it out on me? Or something to that effect. Why you punched the computer?
Because you all made a mistake?
Not really, no.
So you want to get mad and hit the computer because you made a mistake? Because your company made a mistake? You want to take it out on me?
I'm not taking it out on you.
So why did you get mad and hit the computer? Why did you get mad and hit the computer?
Because I had
mad. I'm sure you're on camera, right?
Yeah, I am.
I'm sure you're on camera. So this is the type of people they have working here.
Why can't he punch the computer? It ain't your computer. If he punched a computer, he must have been antagonizing him to get him to that point. Because when he started to bang himself in the head and headbutted the laptop, I was like, oh my God. I thought autism, you know, spectrum of some sort, I'm no expert and I don't know all the names, but I knew it was a mental illness. Even though he said it, yeah. But I'm like, oh yeah, he got a problem. And you pushed him to that point and I didn't see what it was for. Here's my thing. The young man stated that what he didn't show was Tariq called him a racial, I'm sorry, not a racial slur, a homophobic slur, a faggot. And also, let me be clear. On my channel, any of my social medias, I do not condone or let, unless I just miss it, you can't use homophobic slurs over here. You can't say faggot and gay bash or anything. The comment will get deleted, and that's just that. You can't talk about transgender people. You can disagree, but you can't bash them. There's a difference. Anyway, if this was a racial video and that young man had called the guy recording like a nigger or monkey, anything racial, okay? You black people, when we have seen videos of Karens and other racist people carrying on, the person recording, you are, they emphasize it several times what transpired to get this going. He called me a nigger. You know what I'm saying? You'll hear him say that. Or you, us black people, you better watch your mouth. You know, because they're incensed, they're angry, they're pissed, and they're letting you know, this motherfucker said that to me. You know what I'm saying? You know why this is happening. He didn't mention one thing, except, oh my God, look at this is what you allow working here, which was sad to say. What you mean this is what you allow working here? The whole video was horrible to transpire. He deliberately recorded him. He deliberately put him online. And again, I need to know, was this Tariq's experience, or again, was he posting just videos of incidents? Because that's what a lot of his page is. Videos of incidents. And he captioned it. He didn't say me at the holiday, you know, but people are saying it's him. I guess he thought it was going to be an outpour of, oh my God, race. What was the race issue? There was no race issue with that video, from what I could see, unless we're watching a different video or there's other footage. But I'm thinking the Holiday Inn, is that where it was? The Holiday Inn, they would watch the video and they can play it back, but they also put them out. So that part, so if that was Tariq or another guy recording, they got put out because they was harassing other people. I need us to stop race baiting things, making things racial when there isn't racial, in that every situation is different. And if the situation is not racial, you should not be trying to bring up race by titling things or saying things that stir up racist intent. Because I saw the video and the way it was captioned, I'm like, what did this white boy say to this black man? Oh my God. Here we go. And then I saw the video. I said, let me play it again. What did I miss? You're harassing him. What you think in the comments? Was this racial? Did this white employee, okay, Caleb, did he do something to the black man? And here's another thing. The audacity of people to think in customer service, the customer service rep can't get upset. Yes, the customer's always white. But when we confront, I've been upset at customer service, and I've confronted customer service with a tone that set the tone for the whole conversation. And the rep I was talking to had an attitude. She had every right to have an attitude because I came to her with an attitude. Understandably, I'm upset, especially if it involves money, but that's any color. We've seen black customer service reps get in the asses of other blacks that's in line or anything, back and forth. So if you came at him, and supposedly it wasn't even his fault, it was his associate fucked up his room or reservation or what have you. I'm not going to expect, if I'm coming at you, why the fuck is my room? Who charging me an extra $100? The fuck? I don't expect the customer service rep to bitch down and, so sorry. What I do expect is, ma'am, let me look into it. Let's calm down. Bring it down. I know you mad, but calm down. I'm a check for you. Hold on. Hold on. I fully expect that tone from the customer service rep. Let's not play. But this was not racist or racial in any way. I do not like that he race baited this and tried to get everybody on this. This man GoFundMe is over $113,000 in 3 days. It was this, let me hit refresh. This GoFundMe was created 2 days ago. So excuse me for saying it. Well, I hit refresh, y'all. It's $114,510. from 3,000, from less than 4,000 people, they have got him to almost 115K. Here's a donation right here for $2,000. Talk about another Uno reverse. You thought you was gonna post something that was, we was gonna be like, oh my God, he didn't do shit. He didn't do nothing. He harmed himself. He broke his job's property with his outburst. He was shamed. He's embarrassed. He know how he looked. And you're recording him, then you upload it. This was nothing to do with a white person disrespecting a black man. This was a white person who got yelled at. I mean, we can all piece the story. Got yelled at because the reservation was wrong. He probably had attitude back. But I don't believe he said anything out of order because, like I said, and prove me if I'm wrong, a lot of videos, when someone has said something racial, it's repeated through the video because they're so angry about it. Now, he said he called him a faggot. Now, that's not in the video, but do I think he said that? Maybe. I wouldn't put it past him. He captioned the video with mayonnaise person. A mayonnaise person. I forget how he said it, but he referred to the white guy as mayonnaise. That's inappropriate, but that's it for this video. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think about race baiting? I think it causes unnecessary drama and issues when we already have so many issues at hand. This didn't need to happen. It didn't need to hit the internet. But it did, and here we are. But I do think behaviors like this need to stop. Don't race bait. Put the facts out. And if you just, because this is nothing but a recordable world. If you feel like you want to record every interaction with another race, then record it from the second you say hello. Give the whole context of the video, of the whole encounter. Not the middle when everybody's heated. Not when you have something like this happen. As soon as you say hello, hit record. Now when you upload it, we know, oh, okay, this is what happened. This is what didn't happen. That's it on this video. Thank you for joining thank you for coming back and watching the video. If you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button. If you are an OG, you've been around for the long haul, welcome back. And I appreciate, again, all of you. I love all of you that stop by and watch a video with me. You guys are awesome for letting me give my commentary and kick it with y'all. And I love y'all to get down in the comments and say what you say. So I'm out, and I'll be back with another video. Bye.